today I wanted to talk to you about a common concern a lot of families have when they see me in the clinic, and that is regarding earwax. So what is earwax? Well, it's actually a normal substance that our body makes. We make it in the outer two-thirds of our ear. And it is a natural protectant that we have. So it helps to clean, protect, and actually gently lubricate our ears themselves. Once in a while, it can become an issue. And sometimes if there's a lot of buildup, then it can lead towards more of a narrowing of the canal or actually even occlusion. And we call that wax impaction. And that can also lead towards muffling of hearing. It can also lead to some people feeling a little bit more itchiness. Maybe they have some discharge. And occasionally it can cause pain. Most times the body will naturally self-clean it and your normal activities will get most of that out. So we can use some things that are over the counter. There is a few products that are available, such as Debrox, or some people might use mineral oil, they might even use hydrogen peroxide. And what those do is they help to soften up the wax and make it easier for it to just gently come on out. You may hear that some people like to use things like the little cotton tip applicators, what are often known as Q-tips. The challenge with that is that while it might remove a little bit of the wax, the problem is that it pushes the rest down further, and that can actually lead up to a big buildup and cause a lot more pain and discomfort. So what can be done otherwise? Well, your pediatrician may try a couple of different things, and they may use something like an ear flush, and they might irrigate the ear. Other options are they may refer you to come and see us with ear, nose, and throat specialists. And we can actually have specialized instruments and special lights, including a microscope, to help us look and examine your child's ears as well as clean them out. If you have questions about this or earwax, we'd be very happy to see you here at St. Louis Children's Hospital.